We look at agriculture in this country as a placeholder for development. That is something we have to change. If you get an opportunity to grab a piece of land, you have to take it. Right. And you have to get people growing on it.
This year is your 30th anniversary, and I'm really curious about the history of Wasatch Community Gardens. When did you first start?
So we used to be called Wasatch Fish and Gardens because they wanted to do basically aquaponics with tilapia in the early 80s. It kind of showed how innovative the group was. And it wasn't too long before this garden came up for sale. So we had 9 gardens at the time in the early 90s. And we have 16 today, and we provide varying degrees of support. And so really kind of working with the people who make up that garden is really the sort of the fun of the work we do. We're there to kind of provide a backbone. Right. We want the community to see it as a space they can take on.
Hi, I'm Kay Robison, and I garden here at the vegetable mining operation where I have a plot, and we're part of the Wasatch Community Gardens group. There was a woman here in the neighborhood in West Valley that decided she wanted to have a community garden here in this park in Hillsdale. She organized it. I heard about it. We started with her. We were some of the first gardeners in this garden. And it's been a great experience. We've gotten a lot of food out of it.
My name's Karen Yates, and I have a plot here with Wasatch Community Gardens. We saw an advertisement to come to a planning meeting, and we were involved right from the beginning, and that was really fun to see it evolve and become the beautiful garden it is now.
So in my community garden plot, I've been really impressed by the resources that you provide to your gardeners. I mean, the tools, compost,
drip lines.
And you offer scholarships too for people that are wanting a garden plot.
Yeah, we really want to make it so that money is not the barrier that's forcing people to say, oh, well, I can't grow my own food. We also do a mini grant program for our community gardeners. So it's like this space gets to be what you want it to be. It's also a great way to develop that group. You're new to the garden and you're like, how do I get to know people? I mean, you can get attached into a project.
Moving here from California, we didn't know anybody, so I thought it would be a good way to meet new folks.
The principle of gardening with friends and neighbors to create a community garden is kind of a satisfying thing. It's not anything we do much anymore.
For me as a first-time gardener, I feel like I'm learning so much because I'm in a space with other gardeners.
We have this great workshop program. We teach about 35 or 40 workshops a year on everything from basic organic gardening, backyard chicken keeping, pest diagnostics, which is a big thing. Right. And they're open to the public. They're a very affordable fee, and we provide those for almost nothing for our community gardeners because we want our community gardeners to be successful.
Gardening in Utah is a lot different than gardening in California, I found. So I've learned so much from Mary Beth. She's a great teacher. They're just experts in their field. And so any questions that you might have about gardening or any support you need, you can go to them and they fully support you.
So this side of the garden is our youth teaching garden. And we do a hoop house. Our youth program serves roughly 1,800 to 2,000 kids per year at this garden. We work with kids from 4 to 12. They do often help harvest, and then they always have a snack out of the garden. So there's this connection between, you know, food, growing food, healthy food, and how to make it taste good. We have a really great partnership with the International Rescue Committee's New Roots program. We tend to have about 80 refugee families per year in our 16 community gardens. Those folks, they bring a whole different group of foods and seeds to the garden. It's a great opportunity for other people to say, hey, what are you growing over there? And it's this great connector of people. Food is a great connector of people.
Meeting some of the immigrant gardeners and learning what they grow, like amaranth that we consider a weed and they think of it as a pot herb, that's been really exciting too.
So our newest program is the Green Team Farm, a job training program for women currently facing homelessness. Every woman, I think, who stays at least 30 days there makes a substantial change and has a deep impact on them.
Hi, I'm Nikki Long. I am a former team member of the Green Team here at Wasatch Community Gardens. I was homeless sleeping in my car, I met Camille Winnie, invited me to come over and take a look at the garden and hire me. We'd all come together as a team and work together. Any problems was taken care of as a team. We all handled it as a team. I started out homeless, and this brought the life back to me. This whole garden is what I get to say, help me back in life.
I was hired with a directive by the board to build a headquarters for the organization. In 2017, we had such a unique opportunity. Three properties adjacent to this site, which we own already.
Right.
All three came up for sale with one owner. So what we've developed will expand garden space, expand educational space, and then we'll have our offices there. It's net zero. We're gonna make it net water. There was early people who really saw the vision of the project and saw that this was important to urban ag and the organization's role in the community to get this permanent home and really root in. I definitely felt like we are the little nonprofit that could.